Hello, good morning students. Today I'll introduce you with some insect orders. So we have studied various insects. Now coming to the class Insecta, the important characteristic feature of the class Insecta, that is, it has three pairs of jointed legs. Jointed legs means that it belongs to phylum Arthropoda. Arthro means jointed, poda is legs. So the class Insecta, it has got three pairs of jointed legs, whereas the phylum Arthropoda, it has the jointed legs. Second, in the case of class Insecta, the body is divisible into three parts, that is head, thorax and abdomen. The head, it bears the antenna, it bears the mouth part, it bears the eyes. Whereas the thorax, it bears three pair of jointed legs and two pair of wings. So, third important point, that it has got a pair of compound eyes and a pair of antennae. Two pairs of wings, they are present in the adult stage. And another very important characteristic feature of Insecta is the respiration, it is with the help of trachea. So you can see the network of tubules in the insect, which are the trachea, which opens through the sparicle. So when we study the class Insecta, we can say that class Insecta is the one which includes the organism with three pairs of jointed legs, two pairs of wings, body is divisible into head, thorax and abdomen, having a pair of compound eye and antennae. Now coming to a few orders which we are going to study. First is order Coleoptera. Now Coleoptera is a very important order where the beetles, they are present. So in the case of Coleoptera, the forewings of the beetles, they are heavily secretized and form protective covering over the hind wings. The forewings, they are known as elytra. And Coleoptera means sheath wings, that is the hard sheath like elytra over the soft hind wings. So the forewings, they are hardened to form the elytra, whereas the hind wings, they are soft. The elytra are not used in flight but are lifted out of the way to the hind wings. At rest, the elytra meet in a straight line down the middle of the back. The elytra may completely cover the abdomen or may be bit shorter, exposing the part of the abdomen. The hind wings, they are membranous and they are used for flight. And at rest, they are folded protectively under the elytra. Now, very important, Coleoptera are the only order of insects that have the elytra, and this adaptations have enabled them to expand into many habitats such as leaf litters, logs and soil that would otherwise damage the wings of less well protected insect groups. So these are some of the individuals of the order Coleoptera. They are the beetles with the elytra and the hind wings open, right? So here the body is divisible into three parts. See, head, thorax and abdomen. First pair of wings is changed into elytra. Second pair is membranous. Different mouth parts, they are present in the case of the beetle. Now coming to the second order. Second order is Lepidoptera. Lepidoptera, it includes the butterflies and the moth. So about 180,000 species of Lepidoptera, they are described. They form 10% of the total described species of the living organisms. One of the most widespread and widely recognized insect order in the world. They show many variations of the basic body structure. Lepidopteran species, they are characterized by more than three derived features. The most apparent is the presence of scales, Lepidoptera. That is, the scales, they are present on the body, wing and proboscis. The scales, they are modified flattened hairs and give butterflies and moths their wide variety of colors and the pattern. So Lepidoptera, they are having the scales on bodies than proboscis. Now two different individual, moths and butterfly. Now what is the basic difference between a moth and butterfly? Basically moths, they are nocturnal, butterfly is diurnal. When we look at the antenna of moth and butterfly, in the case of butterfly, the clubbed antenna, they are present. Whereas in the case of the moths, pointed antenna, they are present at the tip. The body of the moth is stouter, thicker. Whereas the body of the butterfly is sleeker. So when the butterfly, it sits on the substratum, it folds its wing vertically. Whereas whenever the moth, it sits on the substratum, it unfolds its wing. It opens its wing. So in this way, we can differentiate between the moth and butterfly. Now like the other insect, butterfly and moth, they are also holometabolous, that is, they show complete metamorphosis. The larvae of Lepidoptera is known as the caterpillar, and they will mature to form the butterfly adult or the moth adult. They are having a cylindrical body with well-developed head, mandible mouth parts, three pairs of thoracic legs, and they grow. The larva change in appearance going through the various stages, which are known as instars. Sometimes 4 instars they are there, sometimes 5 instars they are there. Once fully matured, the larva develop into the pupa. The new butterflies and the moth species spin a silk case known as cocoon prior to pupation. The butterfly pupa is known as chrysalis. It has hard skin, usually with no cocoon. Once the pupa has completed its metamorphosis, sexually mature adult, it emerges out from the Lepidoptera. So in this diagram you can see, in this pics you can see the eggs, they are present. The eggs, from the eggs, the caterpillars, they'll come out. Caterpillars will change into the pupa. Pupa is known as chrysalis, and the adult, it is formed. So, if the antennae, it is clubbed, it is butterfly. If the antennae is pointed, it is the moth. Both are beautifully colored. Now, you can see the scales of the butterfly. Such a colorful scales, they are present on the head, proboscis, as well as the wings. When you touch the butterfly, something comes on your hand, on your finger. They are the scales of the butterflies. So colorful scales, they are present. So they are shown in different ranges. Now coming to the next order is the Hemiptera. Hemiptera is an order where the bugs, they are present. They are also having two pairs of wings. Sometimes they are wingless also, and sometimes they have only the 4 wings. So wings are generally membranous, and in some species they may be hardened at the base. Parenting or sucking mouth parts, they are present. Antenna vary. They can be short, long or conspicuous. The young of Hemiptera look like the small adults. Therefore, they are known as nymphs. The order is divided into 3 suborders. That is, it includes true bugs, hoppers and aphids or the seal insects. So this is regarding the bugs. Now the basic difference between the Coleoptera and Hemiptera is, there the first pair of wing is changed into the elytra. But in this case, the hemielytron is present. It is partially hardened. This is the only difference between the two. Otherwise, 3 pairs, they are present. Body is divisible into head, neck, head, thorax and abdomen. So, hemielytra is present in the case of the bugs. So, these are again the elytra. This is again the Hemiptera order. That is, these are the hoppers, leaf hoppers. Psyllids, they are present. Then the aphids, they are there. Some are wingless, some are with wings. So whenever the wings are present, two pairs they are there. Now coming to the next order, that is the Diptera. Now Diptera, from its name indicates, that is, it includes the insect with one pair of wing. It includes flies, mosquitoes. One pair of wing is present. Actually, the second pair of wing is modified to halteres. They are for balancing. So dumbbell shaped, they help the individual to fly, to balance during the flight. So the Diptera undergoes process of complete metamorphosis. The life cycle, it includes egg, larva, pupa and adult. So this is regarding housefly. So here one pair of wing is functional, one pair of wings is modified into halter. So in this two red colored arrow, you can see the structure of the halteres. They are the dumbbell shaped structures and they are responsible for acting as balancer during the flight. So in this you can see the housefly, the egg of the housefly changes into the larvae, pupae and the adult, and similarly the mosquito larva and the pupa and the adult. So this is regarding the Diptera. Now coming to the next order, that is the Orthoptera. So Orthoptera, they are having the cylindrical body with elongated hind legs and musculature adapted for jumping. They have mandibulate mouth parts for biting and chewing, large compound eyes. They are present. The antenna, they have multiple joints and filiform type. First and third segment of thorax, they are larger, whereas the second segment is smaller. They have two pairs of wings which are held overlapping the abdomen at rest. The forewings or the tegmena are narrower than the hind wings. They are hardened at the base while the hind wing is membranous. The Orthoptera have porometabolous lifestyle, that is, incomplete metamorphosis is shown. The use of sound is generally crucial in courtship, and most species, which is produced by the femur of the leg, the eggs hatch and the young nymphs resembles the adult, but they lack the wings and the gonads. They are also known as hoppers. Through successive molts, the nymphs develop wings until their final molt into the mature adult with fully developed wings and the gonads. This is the structure of the Orthoptera with very strong hind leg, which is used for jumping. Antenna is present, compound eyes, they are there, mouth parts, they are very strong, and the body is divisible into head, thorax and. So these are some of the examples of Orthopterans, that is the grasshoppers with very strong hind legs. The fertilized egg, it changes into nymph. Different nymphal forms they are there, which are formed by the molting. So molting is a very important process in the case of the insect. It is also known as ecdysis. Here what happens, the outer skin is removed and a new cuticle is formed for further growth of the organism. So I hope the different characteristics of orders, they are clear to you. Thank you.